Good morning, students. Welcome back to your English class. Today, we will do the composition. How to write a letter. So, let's begin. Letter writing. What is a letter? A letter is one of the most important means of communication. It not only conveys information, but also an impression of the personality of the writer. Letter writing is an art, and the main purpose of a letter is to convey a message. It depends on the writer as to how effectively that message can be conveyed. Letters are mainly of two kinds. One, informal letters. Two, formal letters. What is an informal letter? Informal letters are usually written to our friends and relatives. So, the language is personal. In short, we write informal letters to our dear and near ones. Now, what is a formal letter? Formal letters are written to official bodies, schools, colleges, etc., to make requests or complaints. Leave application is example for a formal letter. We are very familiar writing leave application. Right, children? Before writing a letter, you should know the six main parts. A letter has six main parts. One, the heading consists of the writer's address and the date. Two, the salutation or courtesy greeting depends upon the relation shared between the writer and the reader. The position of the salutation is at the left hand of the first page at the lower level than the heading. Position of the salutation is very important. Now, the third point, the communication or message is, of course, the letter itself. The letter should be divided into paragraphs to mark the change in subject matter. The opening sentence sets the tone of the letter. It should either be in response to an earlier communication or have a reference to the subject of the letter. 4. The subscription or courtesy leave taking or concluding sentence rounds off the subject matter. It may end with the topic itself. 5. The complimentary clause comes immediately after the closing line. Last point, the 6th point. The signature or the name of the writer appears at the end. So, a letter has 6 main parts. 1. The heading. 2. The salutation. 3. The communication. 4. The subscription. 5. The complimentary clause. 6. The signature. 9. I will show you an example of an informal or personal letter. Let us read this letter that Akash has written to thank his uncle for the birthday gift he has sent. At the very first, we want to write sender's address and the date. 341 Egdalia Place, Gary Hut, Kolkata 70019. 15 June 2020. So this is the sender's address and we mentioned the date. Now the next part is salutation. Dear Uncle Raj. After that it comes communication. As you can see the image, communication, we separated it into different paragraphs. I will read it for you. Thank you very much for the wonderful birthday gift. I received it on my birthday. This is the first time I have received a parcel. My joy knew no bonds on seeing the digital camera. I had always wished for a digital camera and had never been able to ask Dad for it. Besides, you know my passion for photography, and now this device will allow me to indulge in my hobby whenever time permits. This is what the communication is. We can see it's in a different paragraph. Now the next part is subscription. Let's read subscription. I assure you that I will be responsible in using it and taking care of it. Next thing, complementary clause. Here the relation is of nephew, that's why it's written your loving nephew. After that, signature. So though you can write your name, the one who is writing the letter, that person have to write their name. So here it's written Akash. So this is what all about a informal letter is. It will be completely personal. So the first thing is that you have to write sender's address and the date. Next, salutation. After that, communication. After that, subscription. Then complimentary clause, and at the last, signature. So these are the 6 steps which you want to follow while writing a informal letter. So the points to remember is that do not use abbreviations in the letter. It means never use short forms while writing the letter. Then write the name of the month. For example, write June instead of marking the number 6. Do not address your friend as dear friend. The next point is never write respected father or dear cousin. And the next thing, you may open the letter with expressions such as I was thrilled to know that you, then you want to continue the letter. The next thing, the first word of the subscription must begin with a capital letter. Underline it. The first word of the subscription must begin with a capital letter. For example, yours lovingly, Y should be capital letter. The next thing is that the writer must use only his or her first name to sign. For example, yours lovingly, Akash. Do not write Akash Ghosh or Akash Gore. It means never give the full name. The other point, the last point is that the spacing in the body of the letter is very important. The placement of all the paragraphs should be in line. The heading and the subscription too should be in line. The example which is showing in this video, you can see the spacing and the placement of all the paragraphs. Now let's move to the next kind of letter, that is formal letters. Let's read this letter that Swati writes to the principal of her school requesting her to grant a fee concession. For formal letters also, we want to begin it with writing sender's address and the date. Swadhi Batra, MG Mark, B Block, Varanasi, 20. 12 April 2020. The next step is that we want to write receiver's official post and address. As she is writing this letter to the principal, we want to address her as to the principal, St. Joseph's School, Mandir Mark, Varanasi. After that, you want to mention motive or cause of writing the letter. Subject: request for fee concession. After this, it comes salutation. Dear ma'am. Then you can start writing the message. I am a student of class 7A. I have two brothers and a sister who also study in this institution. So, there are four of us to be educated. This is to request you to grant us some concession with regard to the fees, as my parents are finding it difficult to make ends meet. I shall be very grateful for a favorable reply, because it will mean that all of us can continue our studies. Next, it is subscription. I promise you hard work and good result. Then complimentary clause, thanking you, yours obediently. After that, it comes the signature, Swadhi Batra. Now look at the various features of a formal letter. A formal letter is usually short and written in a formal tone. The style and contents of a formal letters are business-like. The salutation is always dear sir or dear ma'am, and the letter ends with yours faithfully or yours sincerely. The full name of the writer should always be there. If you are writing a letter of application to the principal of your school or any teacher, always mention your class and division. Now, I will teach you the usual forms of salutation and subscription. One, to parents, brothers, sisters, and relatives. Begin with my dear father and ends with your loving son or daughter. Even you are writing the letter to your mother, it begins with my dear mother and ends with your affectionate son or daughter. If you are writing the letter to your brother, you can begin my dear brother and you can end the letter with your loving brother or sister. Even you write the letter to your uncle, you can begin with my dear uncle and you can end with your affectionate nephew or niece. If you want to write the letter to your cousin, you can begin with my dear cousin and you can end it with my affectionate cousin. If you are writing the letter to your friend, here I give the name my dear Alice and you can end that letter with yours affectionately. Now, if you are writing the letter to your friends, you can begin with my dear Rohan and you can end it with yours very sincerely. If you can begin dear Alok, you can end it with your sincere friend. If you are beginning the letter with dear friend, you can end with ever yours. Now, if you want to write a letter to your acquaintance, acquaintance means a person one knows slightly but who is not a close friend, you can begin the letter with addressing his name, my dear Mr. Sharma, and ends with yours sincerely. Or either you can begin with dear Mr. Narang, you can end the letter with yours truly. If you want to write a letter to strangers, you can begin the letter with dear sir or madam and ends with yours faithfully. If you are writing a letter to your teacher, you can begin with sir or madam and ends with your obedient pupil or yours obediently. Let's sum up the entire composition writing. A letter is one of the most important means of communication. It not only conveys information but also an impression of the personality of the writer. Letters are mainly of two kinds, informal letters and formal letters. Informal letters are usually written to our friends and relatives, so the language is personal. Formal letters are written to official bodies, schools, colleges, etc., to make requests or complaints. A letter has six main parts. They are the heading, the salutation, the communication, the subscription, the complimentary clause, and the signature. So, this is all for today. I hope you understood letter writing. Take care, be good, and spread happiness. Stay safe, stay healthy. Thank you.